Hello, this is Spades.
And this is Abacus.
And this is the Tonic Trouble SpeeDRuN. And this is something that me and Alex have been working on. Alex, AgentAbacus, Alex, those are the same same person.
Yes, I'm Alex.
Yeah, you're hearing Sandar. Yeah, my name is Sandar. I should probably mention that too. Me and Alex have been working on this for some time, like exchanging strategies and exchanging footage and doing each other's commentary and stuff, like sort of bantering. How long has it been? It's been a couple of months, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's probably been like 2 months now or so. Kind of since a little while after the year started.
Yeah. The thing is, Alex has been kind of talking about this for some time. He just hypothetically that we should like be doing this Tonic Trouble thing. That was like a couple of years ago, I think, when you first suggested it. And I was kind of cold to the idea, but then I was like, oh, fuck it, let's try it. And
yeah.
Oh dear.
That's fine.
I told myself I wouldn't swear on this, but
it's gonna happen.
We'll censor that in post, and then we won't do it. All right.
We'll do that in post.
I feel good about this one. Let's carry on.
That's a good way of saying not doing things.
Yes. All right. We'll do that in post. We started a few months ago, and
yeah, so it kind of all began with your 149.
Yeah, which was kind of a
strat run.
Just to sort of figure out what made the game tick. And then you did a bit more of a proper attempt, kind of a strat run, I would say, which was a 129. So you shaved off about what?
So bad.
I would consider that a stretch run, dude.
I mean, whatever. Yeah. So the first, I'd say the first like real like, okay, like we're getting to the point where this is a pretty technical, speedy run.
Yeah, and that was
your... It's still full of lots of errors, still lots of room for improvement, possibly getting down under 1 hour, and also some strategies that we've discovered since then that Sandra will explain why I don't know about.
Okay, we're at Squad de la! We are off!
Alright, here we are.
We're not. Okay.
We weren't off.
This is the time. Alright.
So.
Squad de la! We are off! I had to do that again, sorry. Yeah. Alright, so this is here we're starting out. This strat right up here is one of Alex's. He found that relatively recently. You can just, like, take that little leap there. Skips.
I felt like an idiot when I realized that. It saves you having to go around this, like, awful 180-degree bend.
Yeah.
And I was just like, dude, like, that's something that Sandar's known about for years.
I forgot about it. And that was after your... We should continue that tangent. You did a 1.1
right.
1 hour, 5 yeah,
one,
minutes
one,
run.
Hour, yeah, for this run, the time to beat is 1 hour, 5 minutes, 23 seconds, I believe.
That is the record right now.
That is the record, and boy, does it need improvement. This is also my first time watching this run.
Yes.
And Sandar has been hoarding a lot of strats from me, so hopefully this will be a fun watch.
I felt the time I felt bad holding it from him. So like I got to show him this, and I'm doing this like I should tell you, Alex. This is not a perfect run. There are plenty of mistakes.
But
this is my first real run. I feel so. I felt like it was appropriate to let you see it. And you will learn some things, as I have learned from you.
The knowledge.
One of the things I learned from you is actually that you can manage to land on the gear right there. I did not know that was possible, but if you get the speed consistently, you can do that.
Right. In general, the key to going fast on the ski slope is kind of staying on the ground. So Sandar is keen to that. Oh, I went for the speed boost.
Yeah, I didn't get the speed boost, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can get a speed boost there, you see.
As you're running off that little green platform that lowers down into the ground, you just every now and then.
That went really badly. I don't know why it jumped there. That wasn't intentional, but
if you press the jump key any time during your sort of standing up animation, you kind of buffer the jump input.
Yeah,
it's kind of interesting.
I don't know if we've mentioned this in the other runs, but we should mention it again. This is one of the things you found, is that the next platform, not the moving ones, but the still ones, they don't spawn until you stand still on the previous platform, on the current one.
Yeah, what he's having to do here is like, just sort of...
You see there, it didn't work.
For a second. Yeah.
That's what happens if you don't do it right.
Yeah. So on the off chance that any speedrunners are watching this video, we, you know, we'd be happy to, you know, put together a list of resources for you to, you know, do this game properly. Hmm.
Is it supposed to be a secret that we already have?
I mean, you know.
Like, not anymore.
Where's your strafe strats?
I did strafe a little bit.
Sandra came up with this idea to readjust using strafing, and readjust you will have to. Alright, let's see how the elevator treats you. Sometimes the elevator doesn't like to actually go up. Looks like you got a good elevator.
Not perfect, but...
Yeah. I don't know if you had to walk so much, but it definitely helps to slow yourself down so that the object spawns. Because if you walk into the elevator too quickly, before the camera kind of catches up to you, pretty good super right there. The elevator just like won't go up, and you like can be walking around inside of it like an idiot while it's just not taking you upstairs, just like that.
Coming up is the don't turn left strat, which I came up with, but I think Alex gave the name. Wait, go ahead.
This is one of Sandar's.
I'm gonna fail it, actually. As you can see.
Ah, man. Yeah, if you hold down recovery, though.
So, to explain for those who don't know, anyone but us.
Literally everyone, yeah.
But if you, like, you need to hold down left to sort of turn left to sort of grab the ledge, but if you hold left too long, you'll start, like sort of climbing left, and you don't want to do that, but I did it.
Yes, hence the don't turn left strategy.
Yeah.
The don't hold left.
Don't press left, I think it's it, but...
Don't press left.
Yeah.
Are you gonna skip this platform?
I am.
Nice. This is really good for this platform.
You look like you're thinking of something pretty good.
I am. It's for video board games.
Also, if you're getting... If you got that joke, you're in for a good time. Like, if you as the viewer got that reference, you're probably gonna have a good time.
Yeah. You're gonna have a
good time. Hey, Alex, you know what they say.
Oh my god.
You gotta do it this time.
You know what they say time.
You do the... Come on, do the line.
All toasters toast toast.
Nice. We needed to get your interpretation of that line, I feel. Like, each person
only
does...
I know how to punctuate that correctly.
I think I over-punctuated a little bit.
Yeah, toast time is pretty good. One thing that hopefully you'll not learn about this game by watching the speedrun is that there's ridiculous amounts of recoil damage. If he gets hit by this toaster, it's a death sentence. Mm. He can expect to be sent to the opposite wall.
Oh no, I think you will see that at some point. Ed will sort of do a backward somersault, and sometimes it'll do like the same thing as a speed boost, but in a bad way. The physicals get all weird and like just shoot you off.
Yeah. Sometimes. In general, though, I think that's what makes this kind of a satisfying speed game, is the fact that it feels a little floaty and a little weird to control. I feel that same way about sort of Jet Set Radio. It makes it fun to go fast.
Yeah. What console is the Jet Set Radio for?
Dreamcast, man. We're gonna play it when I go to...
Oh, okay. So, like, yeah, that sounds good, man. Only Dreamcast?
It got re-released to Steam pretty recently.
Oh, okay. I tried to do the head rub, but...
You don't know the head massage spot. I like this camera angle, it's dynamic. Really adding some cinematography to the cutscene.
Yeah. Also, I should mention now, I'm doing this on VHS, which is why you're seeing the sort of the old-fashioned timer there.
Yeah.
Whether or not I've added a new-fashioned timer when this goes public, I don't know. So if it is there, I sound kind of stupid, but... This is like just a good way to sort of get a grasp on what time I'm at. So like I press this button every time I get in and out of a level to sort of see where I am at time-wise. played it real careful here. Didn't want to mess it up.
I can't blame you. That little bit of platforming he just did is some of the gnarliest stuff in the game, believe it or not.
They're too narrow, I think. They're too narrow to function.
Yeah, they did make them sort of shorter and thicker in the Nintendo 64 version.
Yeah, there's like only
that's
two.
That's another thing. The Nintendo 64 version, which is the same as the PC version that you're more likely familiar with.
The retail version.
If you're familiar with a version of this game. Yeah. I like that strafing.
Thanks.
That version of the game used a control scheme a lot more like Mario 64, except like
and Rayman 2.
Like Rayman 2, except even simpler in terms of how you like gain momentum. Like you tilt the control stick forward and you're running at full speed immediately.
Oh yeah, like I played it on PC, so it's like 1-0 for me. Like I didn't think about that, but it's not. This is tank controls, if you don't know. But like
yeah,
the retail one isn't.
These controls, the momentum is a lot more complex in this game. Your jump is like really, really floaty, and yeah, it's all tank controls. So no matter so. Your directions are independent of the camera. They're all relative to where Ed is facing.
Okay, so pay attention here, Alex. Might not have been ideal, but like but it failed. I've done it successfully many times, but like
that's an interesting looking jump.
But watch.
You make it from here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's a little bit safer, but as long as you're doing it right.
Yeah, that's the alternative to that is going around some small platforms on the other side of that central column there. But also, you can move during that cutscene. So if anyone wants to come after whatever time this gets, there's an improvement. Figure out how to move during that cutscene.
Yeah, but you can't
die.
Yeah, I just played it safe because you can't see where you are.
Yeah.
This is an Alex strat right here, and I'll tell you about this. Is you just go get this spring that's in the hole in the wall there. You go down to the ground, you get the spring there, and then you just death warp. It's the most efficient way to getting this done. There are these steps you got to climb otherwise, and they're rather time consuming.
I don't know if anyone could get the steps faster than just dying and restarting. They're really insane. It's like the steps at the beginning, except like there's twice as many.
Yeah.
And the wall also curves.
Yeah, especially when the wall curves like away, if that makes sense. That's often the one that you're gonna fail, because you're gonna like overshoot that jump.
It's pretty good. Pretty beta. All right, yeah. Let's see how the propeller room is.
Not exactly as it intended. I was gonna jump like to the other side of that rotor right
so
away.
So already he's going for a different route through the propeller room than I have in the past.
Really? You jump on the first propeller, don't you?
Yeah. Whoa! Oh my god, dude. Yeah. That's yeah. Okay, that's the same timing that you made the same cycle that I make, but you did it in way less jumps, although that jump looked scary as hell.
Yeah, the thing is, if you can do that without, like, failing that initial bar, I think it could go a little bit quicker than what you did.
No, you make the same final cycle.
Okay. Right.
Also, that jump was... I usually go to the next platform before that jump. That's a long way.
Yeah.
So is that.
We'll just say that was theatrics then. Like, I
that
did
was, no, no. Well, I mean, yeah.
The propeller thing was just theatrics.
There's,
I'll just show it off.
There's another, yeah, showing off that control. There's another. I think you had another way of doing the propellers that is worth investigating eventually. But
wait, did you have another propeller thing?
We had a proposition for making an earlier cycle on that last propeller that involved going to like the side propeller.
You mean spring?
No, I mean propeller.
Okay.
I'm still talking about the propeller, but anyway. Dude, your movement in that last room was just like. Yeah, I always play the area on top of the propeller is really, really safe because most of my run attempts end before that.
Oh yeah, oh right. I'm mixing up propellers in the level to the propellers you have collected in this upcoming one. I'm sorry.
Oh, yes.
Oh, we're gonna have to cut and read this whole thing now, I'm afraid.
We're keeping this run. This run is good.
I made a mistake in this run. I get to make mistakes in this commentary too. So this is
old Tonic Trouble science.
I was just waiting for you to go off on that one.
Dude.
I was just wondering if we'd mentioned this one in a run before. Yeah, we have, but we'll comment it again. This is one that Alex, I think, found a long time ago.
Skipping the second bridge piece there. I like that jump, dude.
Yeah. Me and Alex have been talking about whether the super red duration shortens out when you do the thing you're supposed to do, and it seems like it does.
Yeah, it depends on the case, but yeah, generally.
Yeah, here's a bit of a different strat. This is also, I think, maybe just showing off, but.
Yo, what are you going to do, dude? No way. No way! Is this like a? Is the boat gonna come here? No. Oh my goodness, dude! I like it.
So you get it out of the very first cycle. I think maybe you could just go around
dude,
and get the
no,
first
no, no,
cycle
when,
anyway.
When you shot that window, dude, I thought that you were gonna like show me some sort of Easter egg about the game that like I never knew about.
Yeah.
I thought the boat was gonna come up to like where you were. Dude, oh man.
That was an intentional death. You'll see why in a second.
That was intentional.
Watch this. Watch this boat.
Oh, to realign the boat cycle.
Ah. I just made it look like an accident so that people could pretend that it wasn't on purpose. To make people question whether it really is. People fear what they don't understand, you know what I mean?
People fear what they don't understand.
People fear, yeah. I played this one safe for some reason, I just went ahead and did that. Just I hate it.
Honestly, that might be faster because I always get hit by him when you do roll back.
Mm.
It was a nice little, purposeful, like, little fall there into the,
Yeah, things go south now.
Things go south.
I had a bad time.
Dude, you're lucky you didn't get like crazy. What was that? What happened there?
Yeah.
Did you get like flipped into the platform a little bit?
No, yeah, like I was trying to just like death warp, but like it wouldn't let me.
Oh.
I had to correct that one a little bit. So I think I'm. Actually,
I don't know.
I'll let it happen first. You watch this, right? Like, not the wall thing. This is... Oh, yeah. Classic super head strats. This is one Alex found years ago.
Tonic Trouble science.
You can climb walls with super head because
although
it doesn't slide.
That particular application was Sandar's idea.
Yeah, this application, but the method was Alex's. He found
the boat was right there.
Oh, well.
Oh, but you had to come back and get this propeller.
That too.
But you would have died again. Dude, this part is one of the most complex parts of the game in terms of routing, because there's like all these different tasks you have to do in the same area. There's like those two propellers on the other propellers.
Alex, before we go on, I want to mention we've had a problem with that cage we just broke there, where it just doesn't break when you go over to it. It seems like if you stand on top of it...
Why are you going up here?
Because the boat cycle wasn't working for me and I didn't want to wait.
I didn't want to wait
for the boat.
Oh, dude, I didn't even ever, like, realize that there was two ways to do this part. I thought you had to wait for the boat. I thought that the boat was your only way over there.
I don't want to wait for the boat.
Dude.
I'm in a hurry.
You're in a hurry. Interesting.
I never thought
you could make that jump.
Now, I could have just not said this and let some Let's Players find out the hard way, but if you break the cage, the Super Red cycle's gonna shorten, and you're not gonna have time to go over here. At least that's my experience. So you do need to sort of reset and, like, get a new Super Red.
Yeah.
It would have been great if you could just do it all in one go. You could try, but I have not been able to do that.
Yeah. Yeah, I need to factor in your death warp now. Or your purposeful death before the second canoe. And see where that puts the boat. Because I think it would still be faster to take the boat to the propeller you just now got. But yeah, like, lining up that boat cycle is one of the biggest timing challenges of this area. I see you go for the full recovery strat. Now, are you going to use the insane strat?
We'll see.
Yeah, we will. The idea of jumping directly here was this.
Yeah, I'll explain it afterwards.
He's going for it. Oh my god. So the idea of this section is that as you're shooting these targets, it makes the platform come to it, right?
You see, and now so, the normal speed. That's how it would have been. That's the speed it would have been going. But if you're you're not on the platform when the like the pea shooter thing hits it, it like goes much faster because you're like calling it to you.
Right. The game assumes that you're elsewhere and you're trying to get the platform to where you are, not going somewhere on the platform. So that's a nice little time save. I don't know exactly how much time it saves. We haven't timed it, but probably like 3 or 4 seconds.
It's risky though.
And it is an insanely risky strat because it involves jumping and then a platform moving out from under you at an increased speed. So good on you for having
this. Is Tonic Trouble. It moving at speed at all is already a danger. You'll start clipping through it sometimes. Doesn't matter,
yeah,
it's fast.
Moving objects in general are just really dangerous. Whether or not they can damage you.
Now, this is a bit of foreshadowing, but this is going to become a problem later. Like, that's all I'm going to say. I want to leave some foreshadowing in here.
Yeah, and it's not like that tells me anything in specific, because there's like 18 different spots in the game that could be referring to.
Yeah.
We have it. Stop talking. You can skip some of the dog's dialogue, but not all of it.
Really just the first dialogue where he like congratulates on getting the item. Also, any other dialogue you initiate if you don't come back with the objects you need. It's these ones where he tells you about the new power-ups. They're unskippable, it seems.
Circumrotation.
And precision, and I'm counting on you to find me 6 little jumping stones.
Alright, let's see if he goes for the Alex strat. Nope. Oh, he's doing something better. Yeah, you know, the wings, they're just not that important.
What?
So ordinarily you're supposed to like go to a platform to fly into that entrance. But no, apparently you can just jump into it. That's news to me.
I'm sorry, man. Is that like you sound upset?
I'm not upset. So the reason I might be upset is because that eliminates my little strat, which Darian came up with a lovely name. It's the Mushroom Cliff Hop. You'll still have to do that later, though, to get to the pressure cooker.
Yeah. Alright, so, coming up...
Tonic Trouble spoilers.
I want to talk about what's coming up here. Up here, there's like a cul-de-sac, and you gotta jump in this hole that's on the opposite end of this sort of big pillar thing. And inside there are these 2 flamethrowers, and if you get hit by the flamethrower, that can actually catapult you out of the whole thing, and you'll fall in lava and die. So we found out that the wings, if you're using the wings, you don't do the backwards somersault, it just disables the flying. However, getting a good entry into this thing is impossible. It is really difficult anyway. So I'm playing it safe, I'm landing here, and then I'm like taking it in there again, and you will see now... A perfect.
Right. He's able to just run right through with that, with his
recovery
invincibility frames.
Yeah,
yeah.
So we call that one the gliding fizzle beef. We started naming some of our
he calls it that
strats. I think you know if you find a strat, you should name it. You should give it a cool name.
A cool name like the flying frizzle beef.
No, the gliding fizzle beef. You gotta say it with that. It's a Mystery Science 3000 joke. And also the canyon one is the cliffhanger. One of yours could have been called cliffhanger, but you chose not to, so we're going to call that one cliffhanger.
What's the cliffhanger? Wait, what?
I suggested, didn't I? I think I did. I suggested we call the super red climbing thing cliffhanger. You're like, ah,
no. Oh, yeah, no.
But this that's your strat,
call it what it is.
Yeah.
So, you can't actually aim in first person while you're flying. You'll never see us do it in this run, I assume.
No.
Because it's really awful. It's very difficult to control your flying. I think your flying physics change while you're in first person, and you just can't tell what your wings are doing.
Hmm.
Technically he didn't have to necessarily land on that platform and aim, but it only wastes a couple seconds, and it's way more reliable than trying to shoot from the air.
Yeah. If you manage to do that, we're not even going to try anymore. We're not worthy.
The game's yours. Y'all have fun with that.
Also, do you want to take this one? Like, the issue with this one? You were kind of the one who found it.
Yeah, there's a button, another button up here that you have to shoot with your pea shooter, but you really have to shoot it from straight on. In fact, even this angle, I would worry about it being a little too...
off.
A little too extreme.
Yeah.
Yeah, you really have to shoot that button from straight on, because the object that checks the collision with of your shot with the button is, like, 5 feet in front of where the button appears to be.
Hmm.
So you have to get a straight shot at it to actually hit that collision check. Yeah.
By the way, now that we have a quiet moment, I just want to establish something. I'm thinking, like, we are interrupting each other, but I'm just wondering, like, should we agree that, like, I'll like speak about your strats, and then you can comment on it, and then if it's one of my strats, you'll bring it up, and then I'll comment on it, like, with our, like, little system.
Sound
good?
That's what I meant. I just say we follow where wherever the magic takes us. But yeah, that sounds fun.
We probably should have agreed to this before we started, but. We gotta stick to it now.
Halfway through.
Yeah. Are we halfway through? I guess we almost are.
So this was an idea that I had, but that Sandar was the first one to actually execute this flight out of the blimp, and then curving up and making it onto that edge. It is quite difficult.
The art is sort of getting, like, some downward gliding that allows you to kind of recover up.
He's gonna slide up.
Yeah, that was pretty bad.
Gotta make it to the other side of that polygon. The sliding is a free action in this game. They really, really went, like, all in for the sliding mechanic. if you start sliding off of a slope, you can literally keep going without ever stopping.
That was a demonstration right there.
Yeah.
I knew you would be saying this in the commentary, you see.
Yes. I mean, we're better to talk about slides. It's not like the game started off with an abrupt genre shift where we were sliding. Well, yeah, like, in the Nintendo 64 version, it's like a completely different engine for the ski slope, you know?
Yeah.
But in this game, the physics that they used for the sliding and the ski slope, they don't go away. Like, they're present in the rest of the game.
Are they? Like...
Yeah, with, like, the crazy amount of sliding that you can do.
Oh, yeah.
That was just the way that they handle slopes in this game.
Yeah.
And then they made a level about it. Let's make a level about it. talk about your feelings. Make a level about it.
I don't know if you could actually, like, get that rock without, like...
You can.
Oh, you can.
You can. It's pretty tough, though.
Yeah.
Jumping to that wooden platform without having to grab the ledge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I discovered that one by accident. I was like... I just didn't want to wait for the platform. I was like, try that out.
Yeah, that was a Sandar strat right there, by the way. Flying all the way to that little overhang.
nip that one in the bud, because I hate...
Yo, you sniped that man, dude. That was a good shot.
Thanks, man. That guy can get in the way. This room is the Jack Black room.
It's the Jack Black room. Because it makes you want to stop.
And go, oh, man.
Oh, man, dude. This is like the unexpected run killer room. You're going for Super Ed right away without even looking at the platform. Oh.
I felt lucky.
Oh, you got a good cycle. Dude, you were lucky. Yeah, having a bad platform cycle, you can wind up running out of Super Ed before you do the task that you need Super Ed for. The guard can mess you up. Like, this room is... It looks so simple, but... It's the source of lots of pain.
You can do the Super Ed climbing, but it's not... I haven't really found a good method yet. Like, it's a bit dodgy. In an emergency.
Right.
It's a work in progress.
There's a cheat, if you just type Super Ed while you're playing the game, you just become Super Ed no matter where you are, as like a debugger, like cheat. And back in the day, when we first met, I guess.
Yeah. We're not gonna. Never mind. Oh, okay. You said it.
A while ago. But we were just run around in this game and become Super Ed and like get out of bound places. So.
Yeah. Like we've been like talking about like how the game, how fast we could finish this game if we were able to use the Super Ed cheat. Like how many things can we just skip?
Right. Yeah. That would be worth making like a separate category for. I think signs point to no, unfortunately. There's definitely a few interesting things, though, that you can do with the Super Ed cheat.
What do you think for exploration? Time, yeah. What?
Most of them interesting in terms of exploration and not in terms of super play. This is a strat that Sandar discovered. It's called knowing where the portal is relative to the ice.
Such a great naming convention you got, man.
Dude, I call it what it is, naming
convention. Fuck, man. That's what the description is for.
There should be between 0 and 1 ways to do it.
You need to have a catchy name. The description tells you what it is.
You could have just not got that bet.
I could have. I decided to.
Wasted like half a second.
Well, you need to get it at some point, so. I messed up there, but... Yeah, go ahead, you were starting on something.
Oh, I was just gonna comment that, yes, you can move during that little cutscene with the door opening.
Now, so right up here, for this initial jump, you just want to drop straight down. Like, it's the fastest way. Get the feather there, yeah. And then do the flying.
Fine.
This is another gliding fizzle beef coming up.
Yes. Good execution. That was fast for that moment.
Thanks, man.
You need. Oh, dude, that. Oh my god.
What?
Did you do that just to make me like panic? It looked like he was going.
I'm not gonna answer that question.
That moving platform, but he needed the feather on the lower platform as well.
Yeah, but I could have gotten that on the way back down.
Your way back down? Oh, way back down. So the goal of this room is to dump a lot of stuff in the water, to raise the water level.
You can,
and that includes these icicles and some boulders.
I missed
what Sandar just went for there. Yeah.
You shoot the 3 targets and then the rock, you can kind of get all those 3 things done in like sort of one go without.
Yeah, the icicle tries to start this cutscene that I think Sandar just skipped by being in midair.
Oh.
It was pretty good.
There was a cutscene there earlier.
No, but the final icicle.
It only does the cutscene once, I think.
No, it'll try for everyone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh well, we've...
But yeah, basically, yeah. What he went for there was shoot all 3 icicles and then do the rock, and basically you only get 1 cutscene.
You can move during the cutscene
at the same time.
You can move during the cutscene. There's one more boulder here that was right behind us right now, but, like, you don't need it. You'll just need to start to jump up on the straw here before you jump up to the ledge. I think that was you that found that.
It may have been, but it was a long time ago. It was you who applied it to...
I think I found it, you perfected it, maybe. I think I gave up on it. You, like, then you tried it, and, like, no, it did work, and then, like, I was like, okay. Just needed to try harder, because I was sliding on the straws for some reason. Now, we're kind of disagreeing on whether or not you can jump in this part, and I think I'm actually coming across, like, I think I'm actually starting to agree with Alex on this. I think you can do, like, leaping on this as long as you're careful. Electric thing will kind of, and this is something Alex found out, it'll find out what your location is and then, like, go to it, and then it'll check every now and then.
Yeah, it basically just pulls your position on a certain interval, and then it moves at a speed, at whatever speed necessary to reach that position. So it sort of moves in with, like, a discrete unit of time.
You're suggesting it's faster if it's further away from you?
Yes.
Okay, well, that's... Okay, then I'm...
Yeah, you see how slow it went right there?
Yeah, I wasted time.
It's because you were moving slow.
Yeah, the only reason I'm doing that is because there's these corners in this room and it can kind of get stuck on the corners.
Yeah, this thing can get stuck and it can make you extremely sad.
especially because up ahead, there's like a... You can't get back up here once you go through this window here.
So. Yeah, you have to go all the way back around and do the whole level again if that thing gets stuck on a corner. So
now, he's
correct to take his time there.
Once you step on this sort of gray area and it kind of gets within that area, it's going to just automatically go up to that thing. Is basically our consensus now.
Yeah, we still need to do some research on when exactly the earliest possible time you can step away and have that thing. It's just something we need to try.
If you're watching
Recently, Sandar did the world a service by going through the game and every time the game auto-saved, making a copy of the save file. So there's now a complete archive of save files for this game.
Still wondering whether or not I want the world to pay for it if they want a copy of it.
Dude, you know that you'll only have one person who buys it.
Oh, dude, do you want it? Like, I haven't sent it to you yet.
Yes.
But like, yeah, okay. I'll get you a zip file.
Yeah, man. It would be a much easier, much more pain-free way of practicing all these individual level tricks.
Yeah, it really, I don't know what happened there. It really messed me up, but, like, I managed to recover. Lost
yeah,
the time,
that was
though.
That was spooky.
A little mistake I made up here.
I won't say.
This is kind of important. You want to kind of follow that wind thing. You want to kind of curve around. Don't, like, try to go straight because it'll sort of, it'll stop
yeah,
right there.
Got,
you
got
get
stuck on the metal gear.
Yeah.
Metal gear!
Oh, man.
It wasn't even like a snake impression. It was just like,
Don't you have like a...
It's not like he's you know, shocked or horrified of Metal Gear. He's just like sick of it. He's just like,
oh, Metal Gear.
You can move during this cutscene.
Yeah, you actually see the camera.
Oh yeah, I can see that you're moving. I couldn't tell at first. This is a part that we don't need to comment on.
But I did it. I did it.
Sandar likes doing this crazy dangerous way where he like trips on the end.
I skipped the fourth platform.
You saw him.
Yeah,
but it involved kind of sliding against the edge there, which in this game can, you know, give you crazy speed boosts.
go
so
hard or go home.
Extremely dangerous. There was an extremely dangerous strat right there. Weird jungle sounds in this area as you're coming back from it.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I always do this the wrong way. Like, always.
You go the long way around, right?
Yeah. Like, coming back. team he wrote every time.
You'll bring yourself a little present, Ed. A comedian bent. With
oh,
that,
man.
You can take the appearance of certain objects that you are in molecular phase with.
So far, I'd say that this run has a shot at beating the 105. Oh, yeah, no, it has a strong shot at beating the 105. Because the 105 contained the Glacier Cocktail mistake, didn't it?
What happened then?
Yeah, one of my biggest mistakes in the 105 run was I missed a feather in Glacier Cocktail and had to go back.
Oh, yeah.
It was like a 1 minute mistake.
Dude.
Oh. Yeah, because I was attempting the Sandar strat. Of jumping into onto that platform,
and you missed
the platform
it.
The portal was on without, and then I got speed boosted into the portal, which is exactly what I was afraid would happen. Since the feather is kind of off to the side relative to the portal.
Mm.
But yeah, we're in the.
I watched this.
Wait, do. You... Okay. How did you do that? How did you do that?
It depends on which way you're facing when you transform to her. So you need to just turn around when... Yeah.
Oh. Wow. So you stood backwards on the platform. Mm. There's, like, no good way of explaining that in short time, but, like, God, that transformation...
No, we can explain it. Like, this is pretty standard. It's just usually you're approaching it and you're sort of, you got your back against the pyramid when you transform, and that means when you become Ed again, you have your back against the portal. So
yeah, Ed's direction
is
when you transform back from the mummy is the same as the direction he has when you transform into the mummy.
And here's a little strat
for
coming
some
up.
Reason. For some reason.
Here's a little strat. Usually we do a jump into this cutscene, but if you just run, you get a better cycle. Watch this.
You get a better cycle, but you waste time.
Not really.
It's that fast strat called waiting.
No, but to like you can just start running. You're like, it's a more mindless strat. You can just sort of like, you don't need to time it. You don't need to awkwardly stop.
I like my jump. Oh, the puzzle here is you gotta do that.
Alex has sometimes managed to hit those second two masks, the one on the far right, at the same time, but I think that was a little inconsistent.
The fact that you call them masks reminds me of Rayman 2.
Oh man, yeah, dude. That might have been exactly why I called it that.
Yeah, they're like the masks in that game. Alright, let's see what happens here. This is an extremely difficult flight. Are you going all the way with this? This
you said it couldn't be done.
I did not want that strat to be possible. yikes. Well, that skips a lot of stuff in this room. A lot of really bad platforming.
Yeah.
You see that like central structure with all those columns? There's supposed to be like a platforming puzzle there.
You gotta climb those.
Yeah. Alright, that's not a thing we do anymore. Woo!
The first time I did it, I was actually thinking of that scene from Toy Story. It's like, you are a toy, you can't fly! Well, I can fly through the screen with my eyes closed. Of course, what you should be saying at this point is like, well, that wasn't flying, that was falling with style.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, dude, that flight it looks pretty easy in the video, I guess, if you don't know, but like, it is, just believe me when I say, it is very difficult and quite perilous. Any mistake will end the flight.
But, I mean, Alex, really it's the exact same thing you did with the canyon, with flying out of the blimp. You need to get that downforce. And then you, well, the difference
well, yeah,
is
that's the other strat that I theorized, and then that you were the one who actually figured out how to do.
Well, yeah, but it was your idea, and also I'm dying here to reset the cycle.
Oh, reset the cycle. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Basically, once you sort of pull back up, when you fly down and you sort of pull back up, you don't want to be gliding up too much. You want to just sort of trust it to do it by itself. Just don't press up or down. Just do little up corrections, and it should work.
Nice. I might have to start using that death because it looks like the cycle you've got for these boulders is very agreeable.
Yeah, except I did the wrong one there. But
yeah, pretty small mistake. The only bad thing about dying there is that you wind up with very little health, which is bad for this part where the teeth can kill you.
If you do it right, they don't get a hit on you.
Yeah, I don't know. In my experience, the teeth can occasionally just camp. Now, I do this section a little differently. I actually jump on the surface of the water rather than diving immediately.
I think that what works better, that way you don't get attacked by the teeth. We have inconclusive research on this. We'll figure that out.
That way you don't get attacked by the teeth?
Hmm? What?
Why would the teeth not attack you that way?
They just aren't close by. Actually, the teeth seem quite passive. I don't know. Maybe they're bugged or something.
Yeah, that's always a possibility in this game.
Oh, there's a thing coming up later that like can basically break the whole thing.
Oh yeah. There's a kind of probability that your run just ends for no reason.
Hang on, say that again. The audio got kind of weird there.
There's a finite probability that your run just ends in the pyramid for no reason.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think the teeth are bugged, dude. They're just all standing in place.
Yeah.
Nice. That's good.
Yeah. You kind of get lucky with that. It's kind of hard to get him to actually grab the thing.
Hmm. Let's see if the teeth on land are doing the same.
He didn't even show up today.
Colin's sick, man. He's taking the day off.
It's probably the same bastard that gave you the cold. Now, the cutscene bugged a little bit here.
This is the only boss battle in the game.
Yeah. Well, except the Robo Suitcase.
Oh yeah, Robo Suitcase.
I forgot that was the boss. That's how intimidating he is. Yeah. Oof.
Yeah. That ain't in there. You gotta to kill these people. You gotta hit them, and then they'll spin in the opposite direction that you hit them from. And you gotta hit them into walls.
You'll send them flying off, like cartwheeling off or whatever.
Cartwheeling off.
I don't know. For lack of a better term.
So, shout-outs to Perry.
That was Perry Strat, this one, coming up?
Yeah.
Oh, dude.
This one coming up is Perry Strat.
By the way, message to Perry. I know you really believed in me. I'm sorry for the mistakes I made, but I hope the Strats so far have made up for it.
I'm sure he'll still be your number one fan.
I thank you for your support, Perry.
Nice flight.
Yeah. The alternative
there is you hit that little target two more times, resulting in two more slow animations, and then it drops a little staircase into that room that you can use to climb up there. So that strat, the flight, is a little more dangerous. Messing it up would be a run-ending mistake. Multi-minute mistake.
But I think you
actually, it would probably be like a one-minute mistake.
Mm.
But yeah, definitely run-ending. This room has some, like, weird sentimental value for me for some reason.
Why?
Whenever I come to this room, I feel kind of just, you know...
I don't think we have much history here either, like, you and me. Me and Alex were doing a lot of investigative stuff on the pyramid because there were two spades that we just couldn't find. And so...
Yeah.
Several years ago, we
literally didn't 100% this game until,
A few years ago.
Quite a few years ago.
Yeah, we were like doing like these sessions where we would like Skype and like play the game at the same time. We're like treasure hunting for these things. I think you found the one, I found the other. So it worked out quite nicely.
Yeah. What was the other one that we were missing? Like, I know the one, but
yeah, the one with the underground, right? The other one's right up here under the step there. Now here's where the game can screw you over. You're like, you become this duck, and that makes this water flow over. But there seems to be at least three different states of how high the water goes, and in one of them, it's just
It's game over, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. The water can be at just different levels depending on the game.
Now, if you observe here, usually the water has this film on top of it to indicate that it's water, but as you can see, I'm already walking slow. There's no texture. The texture starts right there.
Oh, I didn't even realize
Yeah,
that.
So there's something definitely wrong.
This is an acceptable water level, though. The fact that he saw that water that he saw tells him that he knows that his game isn't over yet. Mm. Which is good. There is a water level that could just make the game unprogressible, though.
Yeah. And sometimes after this one cutscene, Ed gets, like, stuck.
Yeah.
Actually, he gets stuck.
The optimal water level is the lowest water level.
Okay.
Because you can actually swim through that corridor without having to go through the animation of putting the little helmet on.
Yeah.
But yes, end of the water section. We're out of the woods. Actually, if you fall down here, is there any way to get back up?
Fall down there.
Down to the little hole right there.
Oh, yeah, like, just past that? Yeah, there is. There's sort of a kind of a stair thing, in a way. Ledges that you can kind of climb up.
I see, interesting. So it's really bad. I never thought about that, but like, oh, there's like death down there. I'm death.
Now, you're supposed to hit
perennial
this...
question.
Go ahead.
I was gonna ask if you were gonna hit the faucet or not.
No, you're supposed to hit the faucet and then it'll fill up with water and you can swim across to the other side. But you can really just fly across if you know what you're doing.
Really,
you just gotta cancel the flight at the right point.
You can actually make the flight from the faucet. You don't need to get onto the, oh, you're doing that now. Yeah, that's how I usually make
this flight. Yeah, I figured it was a little too tricky. I've actually once managed to fly all the way to the portal just flying, but...
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, that's another Sandar discovery, that you can just jump there. The alternative is watch a cutscene where the way across gets raised up.
You bring up these stairs, and you have to hit the thing on just to the left of it. You want to strafe onto the stairs, but it has collision, and this has been a very... this has been a source of huge irritation for Alex, especially. I've seen you do it,
it's,
man.
It's a little movement error that I've made in a lot of my attempts.
Yeah. It's frustrating. And now for the tricky part.
Energy. For that I'll need six piggy banks. I'll probably just calculate the number six there, like it's not the same amount of everything that he has seen there.
What?
I'll need, well, let's say six. Alright, mushroom cliff hop. This is my baby. This strat is my baby.
Sorry, dude.
Oh, you're doing it the sine way.
Yeah.
Can we still call it the mushroom cliff hop?
Yeah, I mean, well, it would be the mushroom sine hop.
Mushroom sine hop, yeah.
Oh, mushroom sine hop.
Part two, the sine cliff hop.
Inspired by the mushroom cliff hop.
I still speed boost there.
What?
I still speed boost there.
Thanks. Yeah, that was accidental.
Have to admit that. I'm trying to help you out here, man.
I feel like I need to be humble a little bit. I feel like I've been a little too I feel like my hubris is starting to show. I need to be a little more humble now.
I wouldn't say so.
Oh, you'll know why.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's right. Never mind. Yeah, this level is completely Sandar's domain. He has a pretty different way of doing it than I do.
Wait,
there's probably some strats in this level that there's the first time that I'm going to see them.
In this level? Did I say that?
Yeah.
Huh.
Well, there's one thing. I don't know if he's going to do it or not, but he's been talking about.
Okay, bring
I
it up.
That we are. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. I feel like I'm learning myself now.
What? Dude, no. We've talked before about how we have very different ways of doing the level.
Huh. I think all this talking has started... I've started losing oxygen to my brain, and so I'm like, I'm not able to think comprehensively anymore.
I know you're going for that speaker. Ooh.
Yeah, it does that.
So, what did that man just do?
Oh, he does that a lot. Like, I've seen even worse. He goes, like, ballistic. So there's a save point if you just walked a little bit further on the right there, which might be good in case you feel like if you're not feeling very lucky in this room.
Yeah. Good traversal of that room. That was solid.
Got a little too close to the flamethrower. The flamethrower collision is just incredible.
It's nonsense.
Yeah.
And then you get it in the first room, right, where there's the poison gas that has no hitbox. You saw Sandar just jump straight through that poison gas.
It has a very small one.
But then
one.
The flamethrower, which has a hitbox the size of Alaska.
This is very hard. You kind of got to run in and get this right away, or else it's you're going to have a very bad time.
This is just bad times. Were you trying to get iframes there?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. That was a really good recovery. I don't know if I could have recovered from that.
No, I was just locked, man.
Yeah.
I was like, I had like 6 hit points, so I was like, crap. I shouldn't have gotten those.
So, I think it's safe to say now that you're not going to do the save warp.
Your save warp? Yeah.
No, it's your save warp. You discovered it.
Wait, save warp?
Yeah, where you go to the title screen.
Oh. No, I haven't done that.
Okay. I thought you had a strat for this level, for this part, for this general area of this level that involved that.
I think I found out that that does, like you said, it does reset the...
dude.
It begins. Alright, well, basically, if you exit to the main menu...
I can already hear Perry now. Like, I'll be watching this with Perry, and I'll be like, nah, that's intentional.
Oh,
it's
man.
Faster that way.
You see, I'm wailing the stick. I'm mad. But... Yeah, like, if you exit to the menu, you lose whatever progress you did after the save point. Not if you die, but if you go back to the menu, you lose whatever progress you did after it saved, initially, in that spot. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Yeah, no, that was a good explanation. At one point, there was a theory that you could do a save warp to get the piggy bank in the dangerous tunnel room, and then save warp back into this room or something.
Mm.
But yeah, I have once again a difference of opinion about that. So this is a fun strat that we.
This is yours.
Yeah.
Oh, it's mine also. I think mine was to like fly from here to over there.
Sandar came up with this flight right here, and then I came up with the die. If you die there, it takes you back to the uninverted room. What happens there is you go through the mirror and the room turns upside down. Well, it takes you to a different room, but it's supposed to be
the same
like
room.
The room's turned upside down.
Yeah.
But you know, you do that, and ordinarily you're like on the ceiling, right? And then you have to climb back up to get out of there, and there's this, you know, this tough platforming. And it's also the one time in the game, the second and last time in the game you have to use the pogo stick.
Mm.
But in order to go on those little wires that Sandar died on,
not a perfect thing,
the
game
you can
saves
just die there and like skip the entire travel back.
Yeah, the game saves before you reverse the room. And so the death warp, you get to keep your piggy bank. But with the menu, you would have you would have to go and get the piggy bank.
Right. Death warps are a viable strategy. Or save warps, I guess. Well, because you have no control. You can't save warp because you can't control when the game saves.
Yeah.
The game auto saves at, you know, pre-selected areas.
It'll pop up with a little edge logo at the bottom of the screen. Look out for that.
Yeah,
that's there, right there.
Okay. Good timing.
Yeah.
Our plans from before we started this commentary are all going perfectly. All of our plans.
Hmm.
So Sandra's using a strat in this room called adjusting the camera using the numeric keyboard. It's not a cheat, contrary to popular belief. there's this cheat code where you can press 2 on the numeric keyboard and it like makes the camera fine.
Once again, I'm really impressed with your naming skills. Oh man, yeah. The camera reverts to putting the camera like 90 degrees to your right.
Yeah, the game wants you to. Oh.
Ooh.
good idea going into the center there though.
How so?
You know? So that you wouldn't get stuck under a platform.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, this water damages you, but it does it kind of incrementally. The Nintendo 64 equivalent to this room replaces it with instant death. That water.
Oh man.
Man, that's a shame, dude. Your platforming was like really good. It is quite difficult to get up there as fast as you did.
It hasn't even begun, Alex. It hasn't even begun.
Oh my god, what's happening? What happens? Dude, just go.
I'm going, man. I'm going, man.
Are you gonna be okay? Oh no.
I'm going,
oh,
man.
No. Oh no,
I'm going home. Oh.
Yikes. I felt every ounce of that pain.
Now, I remember when I started doing runs, Alex said that he wanted footage from every attempt and he wanted to sort of see my frustration. This is the 28th attempt. But I don't feel that this is necessary. I feel like you kind of got the whole experience right there.
Dude.
That should be all the suffering you need to see, unless you're some sort of masochist.
Sadist.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. I ended up having more time to do runs, so I sort of got a jump on Sandar. With doing lots of attempts.
Your method would be, it seems like you start a run and then you start shaving off time. Mine's been more like I've been like trying ideas and then like doing all sorts of preparation.
Sandar's been doing much more serious research and I've just been sort of playing it a year more and just doing lots of attempts.
Yeah, but the advantage of your method is that you get more practice. You've got much more practice on these things.
So, yeah, so, you know, I would be talking to him about something, and he's like, man, just do it perfectly. And I'm just like, you don't understand my pain.
Well, I do now. Like, I'm now...
He does now. Have you got them? I don't know what exactly happened there with the doc's dialogue.
Yeah, I don't know. It does that sometimes.
He sort of started it twice.
Yeah. It's the same thing. If you try to pull out the pea shooter and then cancel it too quickly, he'll like start the animation again.
So just so everyone knows, Sandar is exactly 5 minutes behind my time right now.
Yeah.
So if he does this level in 5 minutes, then he will have the new record.
Yeah. We were hoping to get like a sub 1 hour, but
yeah, sub 1 hour I think is probably possible, but yeah, with a little bit more development for both of us.
Mm-hmm.
Good flight there. So this is basically the moment of truth. Will Sandar claim the new world record? Can you do this level in less than now 4 minutes now? So here you're just sort of running around and collecting these platforms. That you need to form in a chain of platforms. Oh, you're kidding me. You are... Oh, my... Okay, where is he going to get with this? Good question. Yo. Dude. Well played. So he just skipped the hardest part of the game by far. You have to jump across these platforms and
don't celebrate prematurely.
Does this man troll you?
No, but I wanted to make you think he did.
Oh man, dude. So, that's the new world record, 102.10.
Oh man.
Oh boy. Oh man. That's the time to beat. It looks like sub 1 hour is definitely possible.
Yeah. So that's the good news, man. I think with these strats, man, you're easily gonna be able to pull 1 hour.
That strat.
Important to note as well, you notice the save point came up, right? I'll just let you finish. It's like
I'm done.
You're done? Are you sure you're done?
I'm finished.
Okay. Now, for you and anyone who's viewing, you notice also the save point came up without me actually landing the platform. So if you, as long as the save comes up, you can die.
I noticed that.
You can like go ahead and die after that, and you'll just respawn.
You can go ahead and die.
Hmm.
I love the casual talk about death that occurs as a result of games. Go ahead and die there.
A kid's game, no less.
Yeah, for real. All right. Ooh.
Oh man.
Some spicy strats in there.
Oh, I've been looking forward to showing you this, man.
Yeah, man. Yes, indeed.
I hope Perry's gonna be proud.
I'm sure he will be. Yeah. I'm sure he will be. Yeah. I gotta come after this time.
Yeah.
I have sort of taken a break from playing this game in the last week or two, while Sandra's been in the process of getting this run.
Mm.
So it'll be good to go back to it now with this new information.
Yeah. I'm sure you'll find some things to sort of improve on what I've been doing as well. Like, a lot of the strats I did was sort of improvements on stuff that you had already found, you know?
Right, yeah.
The sign thing, for example. You know, like, that was like a variation of one of yours.
Well, the sign thing is slower.
Yeah, but it's safer.
Fuck safety. Safety is bad. The run has to be as dangerous as possible.
Feel like we switched parts now.
Yeah, for real.
Well, I guess it is. It's like
whoever hasn't played the game most recently is going to be
team
forget safety.
Yeah, yeah.
Whoever has been played the game most recently is going to be like, guys, we need to make sure that these strats are unviable.
the ball is in your court now, so now you're playing that role that I was just playing.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Man, what are the closing comments during the credits?
Oh, I didn't think of any. We should have had cue cards or something.
Cue cards?
Man.
There's Susie.
Yeah.
She didn't. This game.
Yeah.
One Mister.
What?
Mister. And there's definitely not Rayman.
Yeah, I wonder who. Like.
I wonder what that thing is.
There's like in Rayman Legends, there's like sort of Rayman wearing like a sort of a middle age armor, you know, like that, you know, middle ages armor kind of thing.
I like to
think that character right there, that kind of imposter Rayman, is the same guy who shows up in Rayman Legends, because that helmet doesn't come off. It says in his bio that like the helmets never come off.
Interesting.
Yeah. So like, I think that there's a kind of a Loki character, I suppose, like sort of this character that sort of, maybe not Loki, like I'm trying to think of like this one character that shows up in a whole lot of places that like, it's kind of like
there's the Corrin who we also didn't see but is in the game.
He is in the game. Yeah. So there it is.
There it was. And we're leaving on the static.
Yeah. Gotta have. Excellent. You filmed me on VHS. You gotta have the static, man.
Any final comments in these last few seconds?
I mean, I think I'll be able to beat 1 hour, but I'm gonna let you sort of work through, and I'll see what kind of strats I can come up with.
Congratulations.
Thanks, man.
Very good run. New world record.
And here, like Alex. Let's raise a glass to sub 1 hour.
Oh, to sub 1 hour, we're coming after you.
That was an attempt. Hang on, let me. Fuck. There we go. Proper clamp sound.